when you will start working as a freelancer, you will get these two type of client. The first client will have money and the second client will not have money. But they both want their application to be built. So being as a developer, being in that scenario, you have to do the smart work. You have to know that how you have to tackle both the clients and what are the services you have to provide. That's what I'm going to talk about in this video, because whatever I have learned working on the freelance project, I got less amount, I got high amount. So I've been in the both situations. So I'm going to share my personal experience that how I tackle and how what I would recommend all of you guys to do when you will be in that particular scenario. Okay, so let's talk about the first client who has money. So when the clients come up to you and he tells you that I want my application to be built on this particular blockchain, I want this particular technology, I want my smart contract more customizable, I want my token to have more feature, I want my application to have like backend server, or I want to provide email marketing, n number of things. So when this client's coming up with all of these ideas, all of these things which he wants in his application, he has money. That's why he's telling you. So in this scenario, when the clients come and he has the money, in that context, definitely you have to build every single thing from scratch, and that's a time consuming process that will take time if you are writing a smart contract, or if you are taking the entire project. So first you will write the smart contract, then you will design the UI part, then you're going to connect the UI part, then you're going to test the smart contract, then you're going to deploy the smart contract, then you're going to do the security checks, all of the things you're going to do that, and you have to do if the client is providing you a good amount of money for building the project. But on the other hand, other clients, he come up to you and tell you to build the same project, but he is providing you less amount of money for building the app, and he needs those features. In that scenario, you have to do the smart work, because he's providing you less amount. So you can't directly say that I'm not going to take your project, I'm not going to work on it because you're not providing the amount which I want for building your project. You can't say that. You need work to make your living. So in that scenario, what I would recommend you, you have to find out what are the alternatives you have, which you can include in his project. You don't need to write every single thing from scratch. The guy who has money, he told you to build the application and he want more customization. So you can do that because he has the money and he's providing you. But the guy who doesn't have that much money, in that scenario, what you can do is you have to find out what are the other existing resources you have. So in my case, if someone's come up to me and he tells me that I want to build an NFT marketplace and I don't have much money, so I can't tell him that I'm not going to work on your project because you are not providing that. What I will do, the very first thing, I will try to find out the other existing resources which I can include in his project. So first thing I will do is, I will try to find out the smart contract. So let's start with the smart contract first. So I'll find out what are the existing smart contract there in the marketplace which are getting utilized. The very first thing I'll do is, I'll try to find out the smart contracts and all the Web3 provider who has smart contract, because when you will write the custom smart contract, you will write that, you will do the transaction. After that, the smart contract will go into the auditing phase. So someone else will do the auditing, and after that, you're going to deploy that. You can't deploy any code like this because it has to go through the auditing process because it's going to contain money. So what I will do is, I'm not going to spend money on auditing. So generally what I do when someone is paying me well, I write the smart contract, then I send to the auditing team and they audit that, and then we deploy the contract. But here I'm not going to do that. I'm going to find out the existing contract which is there on the blockchains. I'll find out the Web3 provider and I'm going to take the contract because those contract is already audited. So if you talk about the Web3, if you talk about the third web, they have bunch of contract. They have bunch of contract for different industry. If you want to create a membership site, they have contract for that. If you want to create a NFT marketplace, they have contract for that. If you want to create a staking platform, flash loan, they have the contract. So here I'm going to do the smart work. I'm not going to write the entire contract from scratch. I'm going to take those contract which is there. So I'm going to pick the NFT marketplace contract and I'm going to plug it. And that will take it only 5 to 10 minutes to connect in the application and make the project live. Because here I'm using the entire smart contract which is already there on the chain and which is already audited. So that's the process I would take it. And that's what I want you to highlight here, that it's not necessary that you have to build everything from scratch. If you get a client, they are paying you well, they have money, then definitely you can build a custom features, you can include the custom functionality in the contract. You have to provide it because they are paying you money for that. But on the other hand, when a client is paying less amount, definitely this is the approach I'm going to take. So when someone's paying me less, I'm going to find out the smart contract which already exists. Second, what I will do is I'm going to take the template, UI template, because I'm not going to customize and build the entire template from scratch. I don't have much time. If I'm going to build the entire template, it's going to take a lot of time. So I'm going to buy a particular template for that particular industry, and I'm going to simply connect that contract. I take the template, I'm going to utilize that one. So that's how I will make his application live. And generally, when someone's pay me less, what I do is I'm not provide any backend servers, because you know that if you want to run a backend servers, then you have to pay money. Every single month, you have to pay a certain amount of money to the hosting platform where you have hosted the application. So when someone is paying me less, I never provide any backend server for them. What I do, I generally create a static site and I provide them. But when someone is paying me well, I provide a backend server where they can monitor every single thing, because if someone is paying me like $3,000 for building an application, definitely they can easily afford like $10 backend servers very easily. Okay, so that's what I want to highlight here, that you have to find out all the relevant resources which are there. It's not required that you have to build every single thing from scratch. I'm definitely going to bring and share all the resources which I use, which I have been using for quite 8 to 9 months for building all the devs for my clients for the freelancing project. That's what I'm going to share with you all, guys. And I want you to just start the development very fast. I want you to build project. I want you to know how the application work in the real world. Because when you will work on the actual project, when you're going to deal with the actual smart contract in the real world, which is deployed, you will learn more. So very soon I'm going to share those pre-existing contract, which is well edited by renowned companies. They have given their assurance that you can utilize their contract. And that's what we're going to utilize and build project on top of that. So if a client's come to you and he wants to build an NFT marketplace or a staking platform or a token platform or ERC20 token, all you have to do is to deploy those existing contract, which is very easy. And again, if you haven't followed the complete real estate dApp project, I want you to follow that. Make sure to understand that how we have built that entire application, how we have connected the entire UI part, how we have written the smart contract, how we are making the calls on the blockchains, how we are retrieving the data, how we are uploading the entire information to the IPFS, all of things we have covered in detail. So I want you and I highly encourage you to go and follow the complete project. That will give you a complete idea. So the two project I want to recommend you to build NFT marketplace, sorry, three project, NFT marketplace, Uniswap clone, and the real estate dApp. These three project, if you build, you know about everything about the blockchains. Not everything. Obviously, you will learn gradually when you will work on a project, you're going to encounter different error. So that's my take on this. When you will get these two type of clients, you have to understand their requirement, that what they are willing to pay. On the base of that, you have to decide that what approach you have to take. You have to build the entire thing from the scratch, or you have to use the existing material and you can fit it and make it work. So hope this entire thing makes sense to all of you guys. And very soon in the next video, I'm going to share all the contract, different type of contract like memberships, staking, flash loan, NFT marketplace, NFT drop, token drop. So tons of contract which is already deployed on the network and they are well audited. So that's what I'm going to share with you all guys. And I want you guys to come and have a look on this contract. See how they have built the logic, how they have imported the files, what are the connection they are making, and why those particular files, those contracts are secure. They have given huge documentation which you can easily able to follow. And being a blockchain developer, you have to know. You have to know how things work in the contract and how you can provide better service to your client. Okay. So that's the only thing I want to talk about in this video. Hope you guys have found this video valuable. If you still have any confusion, any doubt, do let me know in the comment section. And make sure to follow that real estate dApp project. That will teach you n number of things about the blockchain, how to write the smart contract, and how you can become a better smart contract developer and a blockchain dApp developer. Not blockchain core developer, but blockchain dApp developer. So that's the only thing I want to talk about in this video. Hope to see you in the next video, and you will find all of this contract. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, do so. Hit like, hit notification, so whenever I upload any video, you get notified. See you in the next video. Have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.